Welcome to the Recency Belief Podcast with Samuel White III. My name is Danae Mary Louise White, and I am the third oldest daughter of Samuel White III. We are glad that you have joined us today as Daniel White III equips Christians to stand firm in their faith and offers unbelievers a recency belief.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Reasons to Believe podcast number 19. God has been under attack in the world almost since the beginning of time. But he and those who believe in him through Jesus Christ are under attack more now than ever before. Atheism is increasing, and atheists are becoming more vocal in their unbelief. This podcast is designed to equip Christians, especially, to do what the Holy Scriptures command us to do, and that is to earnestly contend for the faith and to be ready always to give an answer to every man that asketh us a reason of the hope that is in us. But more importantly, this broadcast slash podcast is designed to give you a reason to believe in God and His Son, Jesus Christ. Our Reasons to Believe quote for today is from Dinesh D'Souza. He said, "Do you believe in the existence of Socrates, Alexander the Great, Julius Caesar? If historicity is established by written records in multiple copies that date originally from near contemporaneous sources, there is far more proof for Christ's existence than for any of theirs." Ladies and gentlemen, our Reasons to Believe scripture passage for today is 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verses 5 and 6. It reads, "Casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ, and having in a readiness to revenge all disobedience when your obedience is fulfilled." Our Reason to Believe PowerPoint today is titled, "Mere or Orthodox Christianity," from the Handbook of Christian Apologetics by Peter Kreeft and Ronald K. Tacelli. They go on to say, "We confine ourselves to the core beliefs common to all Orthodox Christians, what C.S. Lewis called mere Christianity. By mere, we do not mean some abstract lowest common denominator, but the heart or essence of the faith, as summarized in the Apostles' Creed. This ancient and unchanging core unites diverse believers with each other and against unbelievers within many churches and denominations, as well as without. Liberal or modernist or demythologist or revisionist theologians will not like this, especially its arguments for miracles, the reliability of Scripture, the reality of the resurrection, the divinity of Christ, and the reality of heaven and hell. We invite them to join the self-confessed unbelievers in trying to refute these arguments. We also invite them to begin practicing more accurate truth in labeling, in describing their own position." Ladies and gentlemen, they go on to say, "Apologetics defends Orthodox Christianity. Dissenters don't believe in apologetics for Orthodox Christianity, because they do not believe in Orthodox Christianity. They believe in apologizing for it, not apologetics for it. Let's pray. Holy Father God, give us your wisdom, your knowledge, your understanding, your insight. Forgive us of our sins and cleanse our vessels in the blood of Christ and fill us afresh and anew with the fullness and the power of your Holy Spirit, so that we can faithfully contend for the faith and lovingly win others to you through sharing the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ that we believe in. In Jesus Christ's name we pray, and for his sake, amen. Now, dear friend of mine, if you do not believe on the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, may I lovingly encourage you to get to know him today by believing on him. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Just believe in your heart that Jesus Christ died for your sins, was buried, and rose from the dead by the power of God for you, so that you can live forever with him. Pray and ask him to come into your heart today, and he will. Romans 10:13 says, "For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." Until next time, my beloved, please keep in mind these reasons to believe. God bless you.